Welcome to day four of our trip, Meyersdale to Cumberland. River has started a new tradition of leaving bouquets for our host, and last night's B&B was the first recipient. Meyersdale is a great little town that seems to be embracing the trail, and we had a fantastic stay and couldn't recommend it more.
Go ahead, Sawyer, all aboard. Yeah, go ahead in. So we're at the Historical Society, the Visitor Center in Meyersdale this morning before we hit the trail again. Meyersdale has been very good to us. It's cute. We had to bike back uphill to get here this morning, but well worth it. The Historical Society does a beautiful job inside, and this is the train car outside. Hey Sawyer, can I come all aboard?
Yeah, Let's go.
Thanks, Sawyer. We'll let Mama take a peek. Wow. Pretty cool, guys. Nope, it's fine. No, go ahead. You go tell us when you're driving.
He said take off the backpack.
Go ahead, engineer. Just outside of Meyersdale, we have a bridge. Cute little railway bridge. It is a woo-woo bridge, Sawyer. My goodness. Yeah.
Whoa,
so we have lots of videos of River on the trail, usually because she's ahead of me. So it's much easier to video River. Plus, she is the one doing the pedaling. But we have Sawyer too. Sawyer is three and a half. And so what are his highlights for the trail? Trains. I think we've seen four since he woke up this morning and we hit the trail. They ran all night through Meyersdale. Note to those staying there. And again, we're not even 5 miles in, and this is train number four. Four. Pretty crazy. So what does someone like Sawyer do when we're biking? So to do 40 to 45 miles, it takes us only about 4.5 hours of being on the bike. So there's a lot of downtime where he's out of the trailer, he's eating, we're at stops, playgrounds, etc. But while he's in the trailer, he'll often sing. He plays with his stuffies and talks to them. My husband will pick flowers and hand them to him. He keeps busy. We can go now? Okay. So outside of Meyersdale, there's quite a bit more rural ag area. We're passing, so I'm gonna catch up. We just stopped. That little stand back there, it's Amish or Mennonite, and they had fresh donuts. I saw the sign on the side as we were passing, and I just couldn't help myself. The donuts are amazing. Maybe we're just hungry because we're biking, but oh, perfect. So good. And the kids got apples. They had a bunch of jams and jellies, but you know, we're not carrying that. So good stop right on the trail. We are about to hit the Continental Divide. Before I have to pedal up this thing, I'm gonna take a quick video. Let's see. There goes the river, up to the Eastern Continental Divide. Through the Eastern Continental Divide. Now we're coming into the Big Savage Tunnel. We are very excited about this one. I think we might have to dismount. I'm not positive. We'll see. It is cold in there. Super cold. Oh my gosh. I think it's 32 degrees. Welcome to the Big Savage Tunnel. Sawyer, what? Sawyer, this used to be a train tunnel. Yeah, what do you think about that? Okay. It is dark and hard to see. And Sawyer is singing. Still in the Big Savage Tunnel. It is massive. Absolutely crazy to go through. And Sawyer's still singing for us. There is a light at the end of the tunnel. We are exiting the Big Savage. I cannot express to you how cold this was in here. My fingers are numb. That was a beautiful song, Sawyer. Thank you for singing to us. My fingers are still numb too. How cool was that though? So awesome. Great view. Hello. Hi. Hi again. Enjoy the view. This is our celebratory, it's all downhill from here moment. Today, we have... after the Big Savage, I mean, it truly is a downhill grade for the last 20 miles to Cumberland. River, move over. Go ahead, get ahead of me. Give a big wave. Hello. And we are so excited.
There are lots of great photo ops along the trail. However, this one is a can't beat conversation starter.
We checked out the Mason Dixon Line, which was a cool piece of history to stand on. I mean, we're flying downhill. It feels like we have wings after, you know, a couple days of uphills. Yeah, it's pretty nice. So, almost to Frostburg. We're excited. She's so stoked. She feels like she has just the world at her fingertips. She is just thrilled.
While I waited on the trail for some passing friends, the family made its way up to the Frostburg Museum for a private tour.
But then supposing that she's going, and they say, can you take me to my friend's house? You know what she says? There's no room. Where are they going to put you? Your mom has this big fancy dress. There's no room. Come here, take a look. Where do you go? Or where does...
Where would you ride, River? On the wagon. Where do you think?
The wagon.
Yeah.
On the rumble seat.
The back seat.
See? Just there's like... no room in the front. So if she's going to take a guy out or somebody, we're going out. Nope, sorry, he's in the back. Now this is the art racing vehicle.
Whoa.
The Dodge brothers figured out how to put ball bearings on a Studebaker carriage in 1900. You give this a spin. And then you take the fanciest trek you can find and you spin it and you see which one spins longer.
That's a beautiful.
That's 120 years old.
No way.
And it's gone from there to a pneumatic tire, spokes, and ball bearings in 6 years. And that'll outspin.
That's crazy.
Like, spend $1,000 on a trek, and you spin the trek, and I'll spin it.
We are desperately hoping to see the locomotive from Cumberland to Frostburg for Sawyer. I've heard so much good about it as far as, you know, it's historic, it's impressive, you're right next to it, so let's hope. Today has just been joy, just joy, biking downhill at 14 to 15 miles a clip. Hello, hi puppers. Another tunnel. That is a train tunnel, buddy. You're right. You're right. It is a train tunnel. And my goodness, is it cold in here again. Pretty awesome. My little engines that could. Passing through some farm country. Look at all the hay bales. Everything smells like fresh hay. Still rolling down here. Say best bike day ever. Yes, I did.
You can ride along the train track for like less 10 miles.
Yes, we have. So coming into Cumberland, we have hit the paved section. I don't think we're more than a mile and a half, 2 miles out of town. The cliffs are very cool to see off in the distance there. I mean, it doesn't take any effort. It's just, we're pedaling out of just habit at this point, because you can entirely, you know, go down this stretch at just a glide. So. Well, she made it. She made it to the visitor center in mile marker zero of the gap. What do you think, Sawyer?
Yeah.
Poor Sawyer has a dust mustache from that trail. So. What does she want to do? Play at the playground. The playground it is then. All right, my love. Let's park these bikes. All right, so quick update from mom perspective. Coming into Cumberland, this sounds silly, right? But it's not what I expected rolling in. I think I had all of the brochure pictures and, you know, cute online photos of the historic district in my head, and you don't necessarily roll in right to that section. The visitor center is really nice. We haven't done the actual exhibits yet, but we plan to. My two are still living their best lives playing at the playground, which is a really nice feature, because if your kids did bike the entire trail or even just sections of it, it's a great, great reward for them. So, yeah, we're about to saddle up and go find the hotel.